Walaikum assalam wa rahmatullah wa barakatuh. My question is a simple one. I'd please like to know the authenticity of the hadith that says whoever recites Surah Al-Waqi'ah at night would never encounter poverty.
Okay.
Because I've heard conflicting views. I've heard some scholars saying that it's not sahih. So I'd like to know, please, if it's authentic.
Okay.
And also, reciting Surah Al-Ikhlas 10 times as well. I've heard many people say that a house will be built for you in Jannah. I don't know how authentic that is as well.
Okay.
So I'd like to know.
Thank
you. That's my question. Thank
okay.
you.
You're welcome. With regards to the recitation of Surah Al-Waqi'ah and the hadith in this regard, that whoever recites it, لَمْ تُصِبْهُ فَاقَ, he will never experience poverty. This is not a sound hadith. And there should not be any conflicting opinions in this regard. It's simply not a sound hadith. Okay? And most of the hadith which were put together with regards to the verses of various chapters of the Quran have been proven to be fabricated. With regards to sound hadith concerning certain surahs to be recited, we have many, alhamdulillah. Like if you're asking about a surah to be recited before going to sleep, number one, Surah Al-Mulk. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, it protects the person who recites it before going to sleep at night against the torment of the grave. So this is sound. He recites Surah Al-Mulk. And he said in another hadith, there is one chapter of the Quran which consists of 30 verses. This chapter have interceded on behalf of its companion. And I've mentioned repeatedly the word companion here means a person who used to recite the surah very often. So the Prophet ﷺ expressed about the kind of relationship between the chapter and the person that he's like a sahib. It argued on behalf of its companion until it made him enter paradise. شَفَعَتْ فِي صَاحِبِهَا. So this is one great surah to be recited. It's also recommended to recite Surah Al-Ikhlas and Al-Mu'awwidhatayn 3 times, the entire set 3 times, not 10 times as you mentioned. And that is a great means of protection. If you summon your palms and you recite Al-Ikhlas, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحْد, then قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ, then Surah قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ, and you do like this 3 times, you blow twice, okay, without spitting, without saliva, and then you wipe over your face, over your head, then you go down your arms, your chest, your body. You do that 3 times while you're lying on your bed. You'll be protected against sorcery, evil eye, magic, envy, you name it. A lot of people go to people to give them ruqya while you have it for free. When you do that every night, this is something, it has been narrated that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to do this very often, to the point that when he was sick in the sickness right before his death, Aisha radiallahu anha knew that he wasn't able to do that, so she would collect his palms and she would recite in them and wipe with his own palms over his own body sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Another great thing to be recited, Ayatul Kursi and the last couple verses of Surah Al-Baqarah. آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه من ربه والمؤمنون, to the end of the chapter.